Hello, everyone. Welcome to XFest. My name is James Linnell. I'm a member of the Xbox Advanced Technology Group. Today, I'm here to talk to you about how to build your service-based games with the latest GDK. We're going to cover changes since the last XFest for the Xbox requirements, and we'll cover what libraries we provide on the Xbox platform. We used to have XR12 that governed all communications with your game and services. We've changed that. We now have XR134. XR134 is much more streamlined. It only covers HTTP, HTTPS, and WebSocket connections. Basically, if you are on Xbox, you must use our provided libraries, and those are WinHTTP, XCurl, and LibHTTP Client. Any other protocol that you wish to use, such as gRPC, is not covered by this XR, and you are free to bring whatever libraries fit your game and your services. Our first library we provide is WinHTTP. This is a library that's been around on Windows for a long time, so it's a very mature library. It's the lowest level option that we provide. It gives a lot of options for configuring your requests for HTTP2, HTTP, and WebSockets. However, it is a very complex API. A very simple GET request can take about 1,000 lines of code. It does not have any knowledge about anything on the Xbox platform, as this library was just brought over from Windows. So things like network initialization, suspend and resume, or certificate validation are not handled for your title automatically. There are also memory constraints that you need to be aware of. On Xbox, most of the memory that is available is dedicated to your title, but there is also some memory that we've reserved for the operating system. Part of that memory is used by WinHTTP, but it's also used by other networking systems or your file IO or just the operating system in general. If you create too many requests with WinHTTP, you'll run out of this memory and cause hard to debug crashes and other issues. But I'm not going to go into depth on WinHTTP. There's a lot of documentation on the Microsoft Docs website for Win32 in general and also for Microsoft Game Core. At the last XFest, we also gave a talk on all of that information, how to properly use WinHTTP on Xbox. However, after that talk, we got a lot of feedback from developers about how complex the API was, how much work it was going to be to manage everything and integrate it properly. A few of us went off to the side and started looking at what options were available. The biggest request that we got was for libcurl. A lot of you wanted to be able to use that on Xbox like you were on other platforms. For a variety of reasons, we weren't able to provide libcurl itself on Xbox, but we were able to wrap up WinHTTP and provide libcurl's API on top of it. We're able to get support for most of the options that libcurl provides. Because we were wrapping this all up, we're also able to automatically handle things like network initialization, suspend and resume, validating certificates, and also limiting the number of requests in flight to prevent those hard to debug out of memory issues. Let's take a look at how you would make a curl request with XCurl. Starts with the easy handle. Create it through curl easy init. This is where you set all of the options and configuration for your request, where it's going to go, and the callbacks to retrieve data from it. After you've fully configured it, you call curl easy perform. This is a synchronous API and will only return once your request has been completed. After it's completed, you can clean up your easy handle and move on to the next request. When the request has been completed, you'll get it result, which will be an error code. If it says that there was no error, you can call curl easy get info, get a lot of information like the response code, and there's a handful of other headers that are pre-populated and some extra information about the request. If the request fails, the most important piece of information you can get from your easy handle is this curl info OS error null. This is the error that the underlying WinHTTP implementation is actually returned. The error codes don't map precisely to libcurl's errors, so this will give a lot more explanation as to why your request failed to send. For more debugging information, there's this curl opt debug function. This will give you a human-readable message to even further explain why the request failed for whatever reason. However, unlike libcurl, XCurl really only provides you error messages through this. Libcurl provides a lot of information about what data is actually being sent at the time and what information is being received. WinHTTP hides a lot of that from us, so we aren't able to share that information with you in the same way that libcurl is. Another option for getting this error message is through curlopt error buffer. So provide the same error message that you can get through the debug function, but instead of it being a callback, it's just a memory buffer that you can check upon a failure of your request. Now, let's actually make a simple GET request. The first thing you'll probably want to set is the URL. Where are we going to get this data from? To get the data back out of the request, you need to use this write function callback. Libcurl will be able to write to the standard output stream. However, that's not available on GameCore platform, so the only way to get data is through this write function. The callback, straightforward, it gives you a pointer to the buffer where curl has placed the data that came back, and it'll tell you how much data. Best practice here is to just copy the data out as quickly as you can and then process later. So that way, XCurl can continue processing your request and maybe some other requests that are going on at the same time. And then return the size, letting curl know how much data you actually processed here. That's great for getting data, but now if we want a little bit more complicated request and we want to send data up to the service, first start by setting the post verb in this case. This tells curl that you are actually going to be sending data and not just waiting to receive something. Curlopt post fields takes a null terminated string, the data that you would like to send up to your service. If you use post fields, you must make sure that this string is available throughout the lifetime of the request and to help easy perform returns. Optionally, if you don't want to maintain that lifetime yourself, you can use copy post fields, at which point XCurl will make a copy of your data and maintain it internally until the request completes. In order to know how much data is actually going to be sent, under the hood, XCurl will call strlen on the string that you've provided. If you know how much data you're going to be sending ahead of time, or you know the length of your string, you can pre-populate that field with this post field size option. That way, curl doesn't have to go and spend the extra cycles walking the length of your string. Another way to send data is through this read function. The read function looks a lot like the write function, although instead of reading data out of the buffer that it provides, you are copying data into this buffer. Now, due to the way WinHTTP works, we have to know how much data you're sending before we can actually send the request. So if you have not provided that information to XCurl, internally, XCurl will buffer all the data that you return here and continuously grow its internal buffers until you return zero from your read callback, indicating that you have no more data to send, at which point it can then send the request. If you do know how much data you're going to send, you can use this in file size option, fill in how much data you're going to send, and then instead of continuously growing a buffer internally, XCurl can make one allocation upfront and then send your request. If you don't know how much data you're sending, there is a way around this requirement, and that's through chunked requests. Chunk requests work with the read callback to send the data up, but you have to set this transfer encoding chunked header. This sets the internal state of XCurl and WinHTTP to expect that you don't know how much data you're going to send and be able to send it up in individual chunks. So you just append this header to your list of headers, attach your headers to your request, ensure it lives until your request has been completed, and you can clean it up and recycle it. I mentioned that curl easy perform is a synchronous API, so it waits until your request is completed before returning. You don't always want to give an entire thread of execution to your individual web requests. So curl provides this multi-handles API. The multi-handle you create with multi-init, and after you've initialized it, you can add as many easy handles as you want to it. So we recommend that you create one multi-handle upfront, or as many as you want, and then you just continuously attach and remove your easy handles. Curl easy perform is very straightforward. You call that, it returns with your result. Curl multi-perform, because it's managing potentially many easy handles, is a little bit more complicated to use, but not much. You call curl multi-perform on your multi-handle. It'll tell you how many handles are running. And then if it completes with a success, you call curl multi-info read, and this will tell you which requests have actually been completed, at which point you can manage all the data that's associated with them or what's been returned, clean it up, move on to the next request. The libcurl API is what we built XCurl to mimic. So all the options that are available for HTTP requests can be found on the Microsoft GameCore documentations as far as what we support. And then for details on how those options work and what they do, you can go look at the libcurl API. The final library we provide is called libhttp client. libhttp client is what underpins the Xbox service APIs, also called XAPI. Now, as the Xbox Live APIs are all REST-focused, libhttp client has been streamlined for that specific use case. So it doesn't provide the same level of options for your HTTP requests. But it does handle all the Xbox platform integration. So network initialization, suspend and resume are not concerns if you use this library. One thing libhttp client does support that XCurl does not, however, is WebSockets. So instead of using WinHTTP directly for this, we recommend using libhttp client. So to get started with a libhttp client WebSocket, you create the handle. You give it callbacks that will let you process text messages, binary messages, or a closing handler. So you don't have to provide all three of these or any of them. If you know that you are only receiving text messages and not binary, you don't have to provide the binary receiver or vice versa. After you've created the handle, you can then add whatever headers you need to get your WebSocket fully set up, and then call connect async. From there, you'll tell it where your service is. It will connect, and through the GameCore's xAsync callback, it will tell you when this WebSocket is ready for use. The callbacks for receiving the data look like this. For receiving text data, you'll get a null terminated string of the data coming down from the WebSocket. For binary data, you will get a pointer to a buffer and the size of the buffer. The close handler will give you a little extra information rather than just saying your WebSocket closed. It'll say if it was something on your local client's end or something on the service as to why this closed, and you can respond to this appropriately. To send data on the WebSocket, very straightforward. You have the send message function. It'll asynchronously send a null terminated string if you're sending a text message, and you'll get notified on the xAsync block when it is safe to clean that string up. And same thing with the binary message. You'll give it a pointer to the buffer and tell it how many bytes you want to send, and the callback will be triggered on your xAsync block when it's safe to clean that up. For more information on the API, up on the Microsoft GameCore documentation site. It's also available up on GitHub if you wish to browse the source of the library. So let's look at all of our options again. WinHTTP is our lowest level offering, provides support for HTTP, HTTP2, and WebSockets, but does not have any knowledge about anything that happens on the Xbox platform. XCurl provides a lot of options for HTTP, HTTP2 requests, but does not support WebSockets. However, it does integrate with Xbox and handles all the network initialization, suspend and resume for you. libhttp client is built on top of XCurl for web requests, but provides a more streamlined API without all of the options. It does not support HTTP2, but it does support WebSockets in a very streamlined API. And it also, like XCurl, handles all the Xbox platform features. So a recommendation is you don't use WinHTTP directly. You should prefer XCurl for your HTTP requests or libhttp client for your WebSockets. Thank you, everyone. I hope you have a great XFest.